Imagine the alarm system of your home malfunctioning and going off all the time. This is similar to the experiences of people with fibromyalgia, a chronic disease that causes ongoing pain throughout their entire body. With advances in brain imaging to understand pain in recent decades, we are better understanding this obscure condition called fibromyalgia. In fact, a recent study has advanced our understanding of fibromyalgia by demonstrating the involvement of brain inflammation that could be causing these symptoms. In today's video, I will uncover these findings and explain the role of brain inflammation in fibromyalgia. So, let's talk about neuroinflammation and fibromyalgia. Before I continue, let me remind you that this YouTube channel is not intended to offer individual medical advice to patients. You should contact your physician if you have any condition or disease that require medical attention. In case of a medical emergency, go to the nearest emergency department or call an ambulance. To learn more about fibromyalgia, please check my previous video. Experiencing pain is a mechanism of survival. However, fibromyalgia is a condition where the pain system becomes sensitized and experiences pain even from stimulations that were not previously painful and are not painful to others. In fibromyalgia, there is also more production of a certain neurotransmitter called glutamate. The areas of the brain that are affected by these sensitizations and overproduction of glutamate are also involved in mood, sleep, concentration, and memory, which is perhaps why fibromyalgia is also associated with thinking difficulties, fatigue, and trouble sleeping. The person is insomniac at night and fatigued during the day. There is one theory behind fibromyalgia that involves neuroinflammation, or the idea that brain inflammation plays a role in fibromyalgia. While inflammation may be a necessary immune response for healing, occurring in response to an injury, damage, or an infection, chronic inflammation becomes damaging on itself. Inflammation was invented to promote healing and cure, but chronic inflammation does the opposite. It keeps damaging the tissue where it's happening. Up until now, it was difficult to understand the relationship between neuroinflammation and fibromyalgia because it is hard to see and measure neuroinflammation in humans. But thanks to recent technological advances in neuroimaging and techniques that have been developed, we are getting closer and closer to validating these theories about chronic disorders. What is neuroinflammation? Before I tell you the answer, did you know that my book, 8 Steps to Conquer Chronic Pain, has many QR codes that link to my YouTube videos? I have many videos about exercises, nutrition, sleep, and much more. Order your book today. When you buy the book, you can get the journal free of charge. Just click on this link below, send a proof that you bought the book. This could be your picture holding the book, and I'll send you the PDF of this journal for you to print at home. The journal was created for you to document your journey conquering your chronic pain, and it has spaces for you to answer the questions that I pose in the book. So, what is neuroinflammation? First, let us break down how neuroinflammation in the brain occurs and how we see it. Certain cells in the brain called glial cells are how we are able to see and measure neuroinflammation. Glial cells play many roles in the brain, supporting the structures and functions of the neuron or brain cells. An important role of glial cells in the brain is immunity, and so when glial cells are activated, they trigger inflammation. So then, it is assumed that if there is high glial activation in the brain, this is an indication of neuroinflammation. How can we measure neuroinflammation? Positron emission tomography or PET scans are one way of measuring glial cell activation, where radioactive tracers containing glucose, the brain's fuel, are injected and directed towards the brain. Later, these tracers are identifiable through PET scans, demonstrating which regions of the brain consumed the tracer has fueled the most. The regions that did so demonstrate that they were more active, suggesting glial cell activation and inflammation. Neuroinflammation in fibromyalgia. Recent studies confirm that in fibromyalgia patients compared to healthy controls, there is more widespread glial activation and in turn more neuroinflammation around the brain. Higher signals of tracers, suggesting more activation in many regions of the brain, may provide an explanation for the experience of fibromyalgia, where pain is experienced in so many different areas of the body. The activated microglia also release pro-inflammatory mediators in the brain that sensitize pain pathways. Furthermore, higher activation of microglia in some regions of the brain has been demonstrated in these studies to be correlated with severe fatigue, a symptom of fibromyalgia. This was the first set of findings to demonstrate visualized neuroinflammation in fibromyalgia patients. These findings further cement the evidence in favor of the neuroinflammation theory of fibromyalgia, suggesting that chronic inflammation in the brain overactivates and sensitizes the individual to pain and negative symptoms. Watch my other video about central sensitization here. The neuroinflammation that induces fibromyalgia can be a result of many different experiences, both occurring within the body or outside of the body, such as someone experiencing a traumatic head injury. Implications of neuroinflammation theory. What is important to recognize here is that understanding the neuroinflammation theory of fibromyalgia can have very significant implications in better understanding this mysterious condition and also developing novel therapies for fibromyalgia. In a simple diagram, imagine that higher glial activation and more neuroinflammation are increasing the volume of all senses, including pain, in fibromyalgia. Such an understanding would allow us to explore treatments for this disorder from the root cause, rather than having to focus on reducing the pain, which is hypothetically a result of the neuroinflammation. With drugs such as opioids that may have negative effects, we can instead focus on the root cause of neuroinflammation and decrease the volume of glial cell activation, in turn reducing the sensitization that occurs in fibromyalgia. Other modalities. Better understanding the relationship of neuroinflammation in fibromyalgia also allows us to focus on other modalities of treatments as well. We can focus more on our diet to reduce the inflammatory foods that we consume and eat healthier for our brain. I also review anti-inflammatory food diets for chronic pain in another video on my channel. So make sure to check it out if you want a less inflammatory diet. So understanding how activation in the brain is inducing fibromyalgia, we can make many lifestyle changes to cut off or reduce the activation of those glial cells that occur in a disruptive manner. So if you like this video, please press the thumbs up button below. If you have any question, write in the comments below and leave your questions here. I will use this to make a question and answer video later. And if you also have suggestions for future topics, please provide them in the comment section. And I will make videos about them in the future. Thank you. Bye for now.